The mood is muted, I would have to say. Normally at these sort of events, everyone's fairly effusive. They're still wondering what's going to happen. They're having a few drinks, you know, chatting away and having a jolly good time. But I think most people here, and there aren't all that many, I must say, in the grand ballroom at the Sofitel, compared with what you would expect it on an election eve, not so many. I think most of the people here recognised what was going on some time ago. They went very silent, for instance, when two pundits flashed up on a big screen on Sky TV at 7:30 and declared that Labor had won the election. Well, those two pundits were Labor men, but the crowd only had to swivel their eyes to the right to have a look at Anthony Green on the ABC and his charts and graphs to work out what was going on. And it was pretty clearly that the Liberal National Coalition has lost government tonight, or is very, very likely to. And so a lot of people clearly haven't turned up, not wanting to go to a wake, wanting to go to a triumph, really. They want to go to a celebration. Well, there's no celebrating here. For most of this evening so far, you could actually get a chair or a table or a lounge suite to sit upon. That tells you how many people are here. It's reminiscent of other evenings when everyone has been in hope, but a sort of a desperate hope, and that hope dissipates and evaporates. I've seen that a number of times, and it's never a happy sort of thing to look at. Obviously, any people who support a political party want their party to win. Anyone who supports the Liberal or National parties believed some time ago that the coalition was a shoo-in for this, but that was based upon history. History being that there hasn't been a one-term government in Victoria for around 60 years. Well, here's another one, and Dr. Dennis Napthine, of course, doesn't even get a full term. Because he followed Ted Baillieu in, which is perhaps part of the problem. I think there'll be a lot of dissecting of what happened here. It does seem to be a rebellion without much cause, it must be said. The Labor Party hasn't really done all that much or promised all that much for quite some time to cause the sort of upset that a one-term government is. But Daniel Andrews has been able to outbid and outpoll the Napthine government, and that's the reality that's sinking in here tonight.